The Cause, a Catholic family from Essex. Earlier this year, they responded to our appeal for a family to take part in some of our programmes over the summer.
The idea is that we set them some challenges, so that you find out how their Christian faith is woven into their lives. This week, we wanted to explore the role community plays in their life.
Good morning.
So asked their priest to set them a bit of a green-fingered challenge.
Now, you know every time you come to Mass, you see our rather forlorn-looking memorial garden. Yeah. And we want you to tidy that up for us. But because this is the 100th anniversary of the beginning of the First World War, what we'd like you to do is to make it a war memorial garden. Can you do that?
Okay. Yeah. Well, give it a go.
Excellent.
And right from the start, Mum Sam took charge.
Yeah, let's work in this area first. Let Charlotte have a go with the rake. And if Amy, you hold the bag, why don't you cut it first?
I thought it was going to be quite a good laugh because all the family together and doing things and sort of doing gardening.
That's it, girls. That's looking really lovely now.
What did you think about the thought of maybe doing gardening? Did it fill you with horror?
I actually was quite excited about it because, you know, as Christians, when you do gardening, like growing a plant or seed, it's about life.
I just put one in and one fell off. I think I'm going to be all day doing this. I think Father Jerry's booby trapped it here, man.
Not natural gardeners. They are a little daunted by the task in hand.
Is that a weed over there? Are you sure it's not a raspberry?
Well, anything that looks like a weed probably is a weed. Yeah.
The raspberry fruit.
All right. I didn't make the promise I was Mrs. Titchmarsh.
I have to say, in all honesty, gardening was something that we haven't done much of until recently.
Mum, can I have some soil, please?
It's very satisfying work, and when you can actually look at a garden in bloom, it reminds you of the awe and wonders of God's creation.
But over an hour later, and tensions start to rise about how they are going to best pay tribute to the 100-year anniversary of the Great War.
Oh, that would be lovely, wouldn't it?
I think, right, get the plants down, then scatter the poppies, and then you've got kind of a very wild sort of...
I agree about the wild.
It did get a bit frustrating at times when, you know, you tried to do some stuff.
Excuse me, you can't just go with your own ideas.
Don't come with
mine,
okay.
Being part of
a
community, we have to listen to each other, Martin. We have to listen to each other's ideas. I see what would look nice here. The number 100. We could do a 1 and then an O and then an O.
Do you know what I was thinking? Have 1914.
Yeah, but 1914 is much harder to do than 100.
I think when you all sort of hang around a dish, you've got to compromise sometimes, which is what I did a little bit, but I still got the 100 at the end.
Yay! We've got it, do we?
1, 0. Zero. You can see it. You can't see it.
With much of the day gone, the Cores are happy with their hard work.
I'm sure that once it all blooms, it will all look fabberoony.
Hi, Father.
Hello, Father.
Oh, you don't! So
and Father Jerry arrives to bless the revitalised memorial space.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the gift of this land, for the gift and the beauty of flowers.
Being part of community is not what you can take out, it's what you can give back.
And Lord, make us always mindful of those who have given their lives so that we might be free. Eternal rest grant to them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Amen.
Thousands of people are familiar with this view of Westminster Abbey, but you might not be familiar with this one, their beautiful gardens.
Well, there are three spaces around the Abbey. One is in the Cloister Garth, which is central to the Abbey, the old cloister where the monks originally were able to spend time reflecting, sitting, chatting, as well as reading. It was a reflective sort of space, a social space. And then where we are here in the little cloister is where monks who were unwell used to come and sit and be private. I mean, actually kept not quite in quarantine, but something like that. Sort of close to the abbey, but not in direct contact. And then out through the cloister there is the infirmary garden, known now as the college garden, and was the original garden going back, well, 900 years.
And it's in the college garden that I caught up with head gardener Jan.
Nice. This garden used to be a garden by monks. Herbs were a very big part of their lives. For medicinal purposes. Also, their diets were very bland, and therefore culinary herbs are extremely important. They had some very strong tasting herbs as well that we probably wouldn't like.
Jan, what is it like working in the Abbey Gardens?
Well, the first 7 or so years I was here, I could not believe it. Just like looking up from watering a pot, and you can see Victoria Tower over there. You know, every quarter of an hour you've got Big Ben going. It's just, I mean, we never have to have a watch or anything because we always know what time it is.
The amazing thing is to be in the centre of this global capital, you know, right next to Parliament, the gardens around, and then this still space. And prayer, often we think of prayer in terms of words on a page or a text or something like that. But somehow being close to nature, close to the garden in this way, enables you to go beyond that. And of course, the original word paradise is an Iranian Persian word that means garden. And so that drawing close to paradise and drawing close to your garden kind of go hand in hand.